Hey guys, Thunder E here, and welcome to another Battle Vid. Now, this one is between the $500 smartphone and the $1,000 smartphone. Yes, it's between the OnePlus 5T and the iPhone X. Now, some of you are gonna go, wait, why are we comparing both devices? One is Apple and the other is Oreo. Sorry, I meant Android. Well, it's because, yes, they're different, but the price point really puts a center mark for a lot of people in the fact that should they spend $1,000 for a smartphone, or should they spend $500 and then spend another $500 on maybe a TV or something else. So we're gonna look at that today. Now, granted, both devices are not similar in terms of operating system, but they do have certain things that you can compare. So we're not comparing OSs, we're not comparing gestures, none of that stuff. We're gonna compare things like, of course, face unlock, because both devices do have face unlock to unlock your smartphone. We're gonna compare the displays. They both have OLED displays here. We're also going to compare battery life for both devices. We'll compare fast charging because they both have fast charging, and we will compare the camera as the last feature. So let's start off with face unlock. We've got face unlock for both devices. You've got the true depth sensor and camera on the iPhone 10, and you've got face unlock on the OnePlus 5T. And with the iPhone 10, true depth camera really works. We've seen it. I've done that test myself and David. It looks really fabulous. But one thing to note is when you want to unlock your device, you can look at it. You still have to swipe up afterwards. Sometimes you have to raise it up to your face. And yes, it does unlock really well, about maybe 99 or 98% of the time, but you still have to swipe up. Now, with the OnePlus 5T, you hit the power button, look, boom, unlocked, and it takes you right into your device. I think that one step that has been cut off makes it a little faster. I'm not saying that Apple isn't fast enough, I'm just saying what we have right now with the OnePlus 5T is power button, look, unlock, and you're right in. That to me is a little faster, so the win there goes to the OnePlus 5T. Now, let's move over to displays. Yes, in terms of displays, aesthetics though, that unibrow bugs me. But hey, you know what? A lot of people like it. I'm gonna actually add it as a negative here. But the displays, both of them have OLED displays. The iPhone display looks really gorgeous. And when you're looking at both displays, yes, I would say the iPhone probably is a little brighter, a little sharper in certain locations when you're watching video and things like that. You can clearly see it, but not by much. So the slight edge in the display department, I would give to the iPhone, even though it has a unibrow. Now let's move on to battery life, because of course, watching all those videos, you're gonna be draining battery, and that's really important. Now the iPhone, we don't have the numbers specifically for the battery, but we know it's similar to previous iPhones, maybe slightly smaller than the iPhone 8 Plus. We also know the OnePlus 5T has a 3300 milliamp battery. When it comes to battery life, it is no comparison. The OnePlus 5T wins. It lasts much longer. It is much better in actually managing battery than the iPhone 10 Plus. And that's just something that is pretty standard, especially just on the Android ecosystem in general, over what Apple has to offer. The iPhone 10's battery life is terrible in my mind and my usage. So again, goes to the OnePlus 5T, and now it's 2-1. Okay, so you've used and dispensed your battery, now you want to charge it. Now, both devices have fast charging. There's fast charging on the iPhone, and there is dash charging on the OnePlus 5T. And it is clear that the OnePlus 5T is much better. Now, I haven't done a comparison video here, but SuperSaf has. You can check it, you can see it right there and just watch it. And in his video, you can clearly see the OnePlus 5T is pretty much the fastest in recharging your smartphone from 0 to 100%. It's faster than the iPhone 10 by leaps and bounds. Clearly, dash charging works, and it works really, really well. So OnePlus 5T takes the cake here as being the faster device to actually charge. So yeah, now it's 3-1, 3-2 or something like that. It's 3-1, it's 3-1. So there you have it. That is the winner. And now let's move to our final category, cameras. Taking photos. I'm not talking about the front-facing camera. I'm talking about the rear cameras with both devices here. You've got a dual 12-megapixel setup on the iPhone 10 with built-in OIS on both camera lenses. You've got a 16 and 20-megapixel setup on the OnePlus 5T with EIS. Now, With the lack of OIS, you can clearly probably think where this is going to lead. Now, the OnePlus 5T takes some nice photos, really does. With, of course, a stock camera app, you can take some really nice photos in daytime. Low light photography is a little bit on the downside, but it still does a decent job. The iPhone X does a much better job in low light situations and can handle that much better than the OnePlus 5T. So that is something to take note. And I think the iPhone clearly wins this department. So there you have it, guys. When you compare both devices with using those criteria, the OnePlus wins 3-2. Yes, the OnePlus has pretty much a slightly faster facial unlock to unlock your device. It's got a better battery life for using the device, and also has faster charging when using the device. The iPhone, on the other hand, has a slightly better display and also has better imaging while taking photos. Now, that being said, you can actually make your choice here, saying, what am I getting for $1,000? What am I getting for $500? And what is important to me? And for a lot of people, it might be some of those features, it might be some of the other features from the OnePlus 5T, and you have to make that choice. But I think the OnePlus 5T does bring a lot to the table to stand up and stack against devices like the iPhone X. Now, the iPhone X also has other features that the OnePlus 5T just doesn't have. The true depth sensor in the front, so you can do things like, of course, facial mapping and things like that. It also has a more lifestyle feature, so it is water resistant, dust resistant in there, and it's got wireless charging, so something to take note. Anyway, guys, if you have any questions or any comments, or you don't like this video and you're thinking I cheated, well, let me know. Otherwise, guys, don't forget to like and share this video, favorite this video, subscribe to the channel, and always enjoy your entertainment.